right click on it and click on edit. You will start machine, which will open ANSYS mechanically. It will take some time. ANSYS mechanically, you will see the 3D model. Under geometry tab, you will see some part. It is actually our glass cover, so I will rename it glass. And in boss extrude 2, which is actually the flow domain, so I will rename it as water 1. In boss extrude 1, you will see the lower part, which is actually the copper. Right click on it and rename it as copper, COWPE, so copper. The boss extrude 2 1, which is actually our flow domain channel 2, so I'll rename it as water 2. So you can name it down any name. I think you should name the standard name. Within the under coordinate system, you will find the global coordinate system. You will see the global coordinate system. Before entering machine, I will select some name section. So click on the face selection filter, which is already selected by default. I'll select a face, which is actually my inlet. I will right click on it and select name selection. A name as inlet 1. You can name anything, but actually inlet 1 is a standard one. It will in the opposite part. I should have a outlet actually. So I will go for this part as outlet. As we already mentioned that this is a counterflow problem, so I will select this as my inlet 2, and this portion will be selected as outlet 2. Now I will select the body selection filter. I will select the copper part and right click on it. I will create a name section, like this is my wall, and I will select the upper part of my case, which is already is actually a glass. So click it on it and save it as a glass. So last part, which I will select the surface selection filter, I will select the lower surface of my model and I will rename it as my heat glass. Click on the T under the name selections, named selection, you will find inlet 1. So it will give me this part. Outlet 2, which is actually the opposite part. Yes. So you can see the inlet 1, and if you click on the outlet, it will indicate you actually this part. So if you click on the wall, you can see which one is wall. If you click on the glass, you will see which one the glass. If you click on the heat flux surface, you will see the glass surface. So that's all of wind selection. So last part, the most important part, is mesh. The mesh is the only part which is very much important. So you could go for default meshing, but I would suggest you not for go for any default meshing. In this side, in this model, I already did this, so I have an idea which search should I go for. So for this model, I will go for 2×10⁻³". Okay, and under sizing tab, I would go for use adaptive easing. Yes, so that's all, and there is nothing, I think there is nothing to play around with. So under statistics, you'll find the number of node. So I would go for meshing. So I'm gonna update. After clicking update on ANSYS mechanical, my mesh already successfully completed. You can see my mesh, this is pretty clear mesh, and I am very much happy about it, that the quality mesh we have. So it is very much good mesh. And for this simple geometry, because of rectangular shape channel, we will find a very good mesh. So the quality mesh is very good, and there is nothing to worry about. So that's all about the meshing of our model. So after save this project. You can close this software